children, take out your geography book. Chapter 10, Human Resources. Resources and development are linked through human beings. Now, human beings, they are linked with resources and development. With their skill and expertise, most resources would not have been discovered. Now, if the human beings had no skill or they were not expert, then most of the resources would not have been discovered, developed and utilized. So human beings are treated as a resource themselves, and for this reason human beings themselves are regarded as resources. Human resources are most superior of all resources, as it is human ingenuity and skill that makes resources out of anything. Now, so human beings, how they are treated? They are treated just as resources themselves, and human beings, they are the most superior of all the resources, and the human ingenuity and even the skill which makes the resources out of anything. It is the human resources that made rocks, minerals, wind and water useful for us, and it is the human resources which makes the rocks, minerals, wind and water very useful for us. For example, diamond in the rock form is not a resource. Now, for example, examples can be taken, that is diamond. What is it? It is in the form of a rock. It is not a resource. The miner and the gem cutter turned the diamond into a valuable natural resource. But the miner and the gem cutter, what they do? They turn the diamond into a valuable human resource, natural resource. Human resources are unevenly distributed throughout the world. Now, human resources throughout the world, this human resources, they are not at all distributed in an even manner. That means they are distributed unevenly. Now, human resources meaning, that means, what is the meaning of human resources? Have you ever heard that the book you are reading, your table and your house and something in common with rivers, forest, sunlight, roads, bridges and railways? Now, have you ever heard or have you ever realized this? That's the books which you read, or the table or the house or something else which are found in common, or even the natural things which are obtained from nature, that is rivers, forests, sunlight, roads, bridges and railways. They are all useful to us. Now, all these things, they are very useful to us. They fulfill our needs so that they have a value, and all these are termed as resources. Now, what they do? They are very useful for us, and they fulfill all our needs because they are valuable, and all these are always termed as resources. Can human beings also be called resources? Now, can we say that human beings, they are also called resources? Yes, they can be resources. Yes, they can also be called as resources. Now, human beings carry out economic activities and engage themselves in the production of goods and services. Now, human beings, what they do? They carry out many economic activities and even engage themselves where? That is in the production of goods and services, which becomes very useful like other sources. Therefore, those human beings who possess productive skills and abilities can be called human. And for this reason, what happened? The human being who possess productive skills and ability, they can also be called as human resources. They all belong to the working age population. And what they belong to? They belong to the working age population. Therefore, children below 15 and old citizens above 64 are not yet human resources. And so, children who are below 15 years old, or the old citizen who are above 64 years, they are not called the human resources. Role of health and education in developing human. Now, what is the role played on the role played by the health and education in developing human resources? For human resources to be an asset in the country's economy, three things are essential. Now, for human resources to be an asset of country's economy, human resources which are essential, that is three things are very essential, that is health, education and skill. Investing in healthcare and educational abilities adds to the capacity of human resources. Now see, if we invest in healthcare, that means good health is very needed, and educational abilities, all this adds to the capacity of human resources. This type of investment is called human capital formation. And this type of capital, what is it called? They are called human capital formation. Human capital improves the productivity of all other sources. It is with the help of human knowledge and experiential skill that a healthy human capital can contribute to the production of goods and services. Now, what happens is human capital improve. What they improve? They improve the productivity of all other sources. And with the help of this human knowledge and even this entrepreneurial skill, a healthy human capital, what they can do? They can contribute to the production of goods and even the services. Health is an essential criterion for working age population. Now, health is what? Is that it is very necessary criterion for the working age population. Therefore, the country spend so much money or bring on a public hospital. And for this reason, what happened? Country, what they spend? They spend too much amount of money to bring out the public hospital. Family welfare and nutritional services with special attention towards the marginal people. Now, family welfare and even the nutritional services which have some special attention towards the marginal people. Countries with high infant mortality rate, that is IMR, poor life expectancy, high birth rate and high death rate, have poor development. Now, countries which have high infant mortality rate, that is IMR, or the very poor life expectancy, high birth rate and high death rate, they are poorly developed. A high population growth is an obstacle to the country's development. Now, country cannot develop if the population growth is too high. The quality of population decides the country's rate of development. Now, quality of population, it only decides the country's rate of development. Unhealthy population is a liability for the nation. Unhealthy population, it is just a liability for the population, for the nation. Countries like India therefore invest in child health care and family planning to increase the life expectancy and benefit from equality population. Now, countries such as India, they invest in healthcare and even family planning to increase the life expectancy and benefit from quality population. It is only healthy population that will bring rich economic return to the country. Now, healthy population, what they bring? They bring rich economic return to the country. Now, according to the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, life expectancy in India has gone up by 5 years with more attention towards healthcare. Now, according to the Ministry of Health and even Family Welfare, life expectancy in India, what it has gone up? It has gone up by 5 years because 5 years with more attention towards healthcare facilities, that is inoculation, communicative diseases and curative treatment of organ failures. And now, take out your diary, right? Chapter 10. India, human resources, 2 pages, explain, homework, revising. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.